All right, this is another CSTR multiple reactions problem. This involves two reactions. So you have A plus B going to D, and you have 2A going to U. It's a reaction in the liquid phase, and furthermore, the concentration of the components are dilute. All right, so we can assume a constant volumetric flow rate through the reaction. And then we're given information about this reaction. We're given that the inlet volumetric flow rate, and therefore the volumetric flow rate at the outlet as well, assuming the volume is conserved in this dilute system, is 10 liters per minute. You're given information about the inlet concentrations to this process. They're equal at 0.5 moles per liter. We also are told that the outlet concentration of B is reduced to 0.30 moles per liter. And the overall selectivity of D to U is found to be 2.0. And so you, in this problem, are asked to find the value of the rate constant describing this process, case of D. All right, so we can first do a few very simple material balances just looking at the stoichiometry. All right, so if we reacted away from 0.5 to 0.3 moles per liter of B, then that means we've formed 0.2 moles per liter of D just by a simple material balance. Right, again, assuming that the volumetric flow rate is constant, we can assume that these changes in concentration should be equal, or more formally, that the change in the number of moles of D, so the volumetric flow rate times the concentration gives us the molar flow rate of D out, has to be equal to the change in the molar flow rate of B. By the stoichiometry here, that for every mole of B that's reacted, one mole of D is formed, and the volumetric flow rates cancel from the two sides of the equation, and so therefore CD is equal to 0.2 moles per liter. Now, similarly, now that we know how much D is formed, we are given information about the overall selectivity of D to U, and so we know that twice as much D is formed as U. And so therefore we know also the concentration of U that is formed, and that's 0.10 moles per liter. All right, and now finally we know the concentration of all species that are exiting the reactor aside from A. And so we can do a simple mole balance that the number of moles of A that have been consumed is equal to the number of moles of D that are formed. So the total volumetric flow rate times the concentration of D. Since one mole of A is reacted for each mole of D that's formed, plus since two moles of A are reacted for each mole of U that's formed, we put a 2 times the total volumetric flow rate times the concentration of U. Right, again, we can cancel all the volumetric flow rate terms. And so we're left with this expression. We can plug in values in terms of moles per liter. This is CA naught is 0.50. CD again is 0.20. CU is 0.10. And so if we use that to solve for CA, we find that CA is also equal to 0.10 moles per liter. All right, now we can do a mole balance to determine the value for KD, the rate constant. And here we'll choose to do a mole balance on, we could do a mole balance on any of these components. It's actually easiest to do it on either B or D. I'll choose to do it on B here, but you can solve this problem by doing it on D. And the reason is that we only have one reaction term for the consumption of B, whereas we have two reaction terms involving a KU for the consumption of A. It's easier to do a balance on B, so let's do that. I'll go down to the next screen here. So a mole balance on B would look something like this, that the number of moles of B that are consumed, which can be expressed as the volumetric flow rate times the concentration of B at the inlet minus the concentration of B at the outlet, plus the rate of reaction of B on a volumetric basis times the volume of the reactor. That we can re-express these terms, will carry along the first of these terms, given that the reaction is elementary, so first order in A and B. And this is what we're going to solve for is KD. This is equal to zero. All right, so now in this expression, we have all the information that we need to plug in for all of our values. We're given in the problem statement the value for the volumetric flow rate. We're given the value for the inlet concentration of B of 0.5. We're given the information on the exit concentration of B of 0.3 moles per liter. We just solved for the concentration of A of 0.1 moles per liter. And so then what we are only unknown is KD, and we can solve for KD, and we find that it's equal to 0.67 liters per mole minute. We go back up to the problem statement. We see that we don't actually necessarily, we're not asked to solve for KU, but to solve for part B, it's going to be useful to have the value of KU, and we solve for it in a very similar way. And we can solve for KU using a mole balance on A, because A is involved in that reaction. We could also do it with a mole balance on U, but we'll go ahead and express this in terms of A. All right, so again, we can say that the change in moles from the inlet to the outlet has to be balanced by what's consumed in the reaction. And so we have a plus RAV term here, the reactions. All right, we can carry this forward. And there are two reactions that consume A. We've already described one of them. It's KD times the concentration of A times the concentration of B times the volume. And then the other reaction, each mole of U that's formed, two moles of A are reacted. So we define a K on the basis of forming U. Then we need to multiply 2 by KU. And it's an elementary reaction, so CA squared term here. And again, need to multiply by the volume. That's equal to 0. All right, once again, we have an expression here that we have a single unknown, which is KU. And just as before, we know the volumetric flow rate. We're given the inlet concentration. We've already solved for the outlet concentration of A. We've already solved for KD. We have solved for or are given those concentrations. And then we, in this problem, are given the volume of the reactor. And so if we plug in all of those values, then we can solve for KU. And what I get for KU is 1.0 liters per mole minute. And I should have mentioned here, a little bit careless up above, that I dropped this volume term that should also be included. And the volume of this problem, should have pointed out, was 100 liter CSTR. Okay, so we've solved for KU, even though we weren't asked to in part A. Right now, in part B, we were asked to determine the instantaneous selectivity in a PFR. Okay, whereas overall selectivity is determined on the basis of the number of moles of D relative to the number of moles of U that are exiting the reactor. Here, the instantaneous selectivity refers to the rate. Let's define this. So the instantaneous selectivity, which can be referred to as by different symbols, I'm going to refer to it as this, but different textbooks use different symbols. The instantaneous selectivity is defined as the rate of formation of D over the rate of formation of U. And at the inlet of a tubular reactor, the rate will be determined by the inlet concentrations at the reactor. Okay, and so the reaction, again, is such that the rate of formation of D is equal to KD times the concentration of A times the concentration of B. But that reaction is elementary. And RU, and this is the inlet concentrations, is equal to KU times CA naught squared. And so now we can just plug in the values that we solved for earlier. KD was determined to be 0.67 liters per mole minute. CA naught was 0.5 moles per liter. And so we'll see B naught. And then KU we just determined to be 1.0 liters per mole minute. And once again, we are taking the square of 0.5 mole per liter, because it's CA naught squared. And so these terms obviously cancel, and we've just divided by 1 here. So the instantaneous selectivity to the desired product over the undesired product at the inlet of the reactor is 0.67. Right, and this instantaneous selectivity to the desired product is a lot lower at the inlet of the reactor, the outlet of the reactor, of a CSTR. And that's because of the second order behavior in A of this reaction. That because but this reaction consumes A, as well as this reaction, but only this reaction consumes B, that as the reaction proceeds, you'll consume A faster than you will B. And so the higher the conversion in this reaction setup, the more the selectivity is going to favor forming D, because you'll have less A, but still a lot of B present as the reaction proceeds, due to the fact that A is only A is being consumed in forming the undesired reaction.